I mean, yung ano, yung projector screen, is it clear?
I mean, yeah. There you go. Yeah.
Alright. I just learned that yesterday. By the way, anytime this is presented each time, take note of what is printed in red, no? That is the one that is highlighted for that whole statement. So now, the one highlighted here is the purchase of building. And we have discussed how to, let's just say that this piece of information was not given to us in the additional data, okay? Okay, first of all, sige, let's go to the balance sheet page. We'll be flipping pages, ha? All throughout. What page is that, Ciara? And then in the additional information down below, is there anything indicated about the building being bought?
Yes.
What number? Number four in the additional data says that there was building purchased. Do you see it?
Yes.
Let's just say that it is not there. Will you be able to figure out that there was 120,000 worth of building?
Yes. So.
Okay. For the no, why not? Oh, see. For the yes, how?
Because you can see it in the balance sheet.
Check the balance sheet. Check the balance sheet for building, correct?
Yes.
And you find the difference. But then there is a component also of an array. Isn't there a component, unless there is a component of depreciation? But let's just say it's just straightforward. You compare the difference between the current year and the previous year for the line item building. In this particular case, what are the numbers, Jasmine? For building,
for 2017,
okay. 160.
And then for 2016, it's 40,000.
Hence, does it justify it?
Yeah.
Yes. So, with the information, that's kind of like spoon feeding. If there is a twist, I may not give you that additional information, right? And you will have to figure it out yourself. Because in the real world, sometimes there are no additional information given, okay? So you have to just do the simple math here. Okay, this is easy. Okay, because this is a straight out just one transaction purchase. In the next item after building in the balance sheet, what is it? What is the next line item? Equipment. Is equipment after?
Yeah.
Ah, okay, so it's accumulated depreciation of building. But then, after the accumulated depreciation of building, what's next?
Equipment.
Okay, let's analyze equipment as we have started analyzing it in the other section yesterday. I don't think we started in this section, the analysis of building, did we?
Section
8. Section 8. Did we start with, I'm sorry, equipment. Did we start equipment?
Yes.
Okay, I could not remember. Okay, let's establish what was given first, okay? For equipment, is there additional data? Okay, give me all the additional pieces of information from that listing that concerns equipment. Number one, what? Ike's there. How much? It says there that depreciation for building
for
is
equipment.
I keep on saying building when I mean equipment. Huh? By moon. What is?
3,000.
Alright, and anything else that you see?
Sold equipment, so the book value is 7,000.
Sold equipment. So what is it exactly? Sold equipment for 4,000. Where? Yes? Did you read? Ay, may nakalagay pa.
Cost is 8,000.
Did this cost?
Cost is 8,000.
There's 1,000.
So that's why it was 7,000. It just takes PayPal.
Ah, okay, it's okay, it's all. Alright. Anything else? I think there's one more.
They purchased new equipment.
Okay, it's nice and dandy if it's all given like this, okay? So, let me analyze this with you, because with the analysis, even without this particularly or not completely, we can figure them out, okay? In order to analyze it, we need at very least two T accounts, right? The first T account is what? Equipment and accumulated depreciation that is dedicated for equipment. Because we know we have another accumulated depreciation account, right? For building. Okay? So let's just say that there is that accumulated depreciation account for building here. The total of this plus this is actually the one that is showing there. Or is it separate?
Even the first one is separate for the second one, it's not common.
Anyway, it's related. But just so you know, there is a separate one. Okay. So now, give me balances, beginning and ending balances for each account, each of the two accounts.
Equipment
is 10,000 beginning, right? And then ending is 27. Okay. And then for this?
1,000.
This is 1,000 here.
3,000.
Guys, if you do not know how to work out a P account, I suggest you master this right now. You know why? Mana is full of P accounts. That's how. If this is something that you do not understand right now, learn it, because it should have been learned. Should have been learned last sem. Okay? All right. So we said that from 10 to 27, the jump must be, if we don't know anything, we don't know this, the jump must be 17. Yes? On the left side to complete the math. Okay. But then, and then this one, D to this is the jump of 2,000, right? Okay. But then we know that for one, our depreciation, total depreciation expense in the income statement is actually 9,000.
Yeah.
It's 9,000. 9,000 is the total depreciation found in the
income statement.
Very good. In the income statement. Six of which belongs to building. Hence, we know that 3,000 really belongs to equipment because there are only two PP&E items. So now, that raises the question. If there was depreciation expense, they credited to accumulated depreciation for equipment of 3,000, why the hell is it just a difference of 2,000? Okay? Are you following me? It is not adding up, right? So that means this is not true. This is not true, right? What is true? What's true is that there is a 3 here. Okay, are you still with me?
Yes.
Parang I've lost some.
Yeah, miss.
Okay, so this one. This one, it requires parang deductive reasoning. Okay? So this one is true. So in order for this to be true, and this true still, okay, there has to be something here to make the math, to have the math make sense, right? Because 1 plus 3 is 4, which is not 3. 4,000 here is not equal to this. So in order for this to be true, there needs to be 1,000 here, right? So did I get to establish these two numbers?
Yes.
Will you now be able to understand or analyze it in such a manner? If I just gave you bits and pieces of information, incomplete. Can you analyze accumulated depreciation in that manner? Yes? Okay, good. All right. So now, here's the thing. This one, we will see is not true again. Why? One information that we will know it's probably going to be given in another kind of more complicated set of questions will be that they purchased new equipment for 25. Okay? 25 they purchased, correct? Okay. So now, kind of like the same model or template here, the math again does not make sense. Because 10 plus 25 is not 27. Okay? Now the step to force this number in, is now a credit to equipment. Okay? So, what is that number if you do the simple math?
8,000.
Now that we have filled out the numbers and they do add up now, let's assign transactions for each day. Anytime that there is a left side addition to an asset like equipment, that represents a purchase, right? Okay. So this is a purchase. Anytime that there is a right side, it is selling or disposal. Okay? Alright? Okay. And this time naman, in analyzing this, anytime there is a right side in accumulated depreciation, it is matching depreciation expense. Right? Because the entry is debit depreciation expense, credit accumulated depreciation, right? All right. So, but anytime that you see, and this is kind of rare, anytime that you see a left side in accumulated depreciation, there is selling or retirement. Retirement meaning, it's not going to be used anymore, cannot be turned into money. It's all junk. You've retired it. You've disposed of it. Okay? Or maybe that's retirement or disposal. All kind of signifying the same thing, but, some with money, some without. Okay? Alright. So, this one takes care of itself because this is partnered with depreciation expense. This one takes care of itself. This is probably partnered with cash. Okay? Or accounts payable or whatever, or notes payable when they purchased. But what really is the partner is these two. Because it is both representing selling or disposing. Okay? Have I confused you enough? Kaya pa? Labs! Kaya mo pa ba? Okay, good. So, now that I have this, I can just remove this altogether and know that I sold equipment, a piece of equipment bearing the acquisition cost of how much?
8,000.
Bearing an accumulated depreciation matched with it of?
1,000.
Hence, having a book value of?
7,000.
Okay, established? So, did you see me establish first what matched together in the two accounts, right? And then partnering them like this. Okay, all right. So, next thing I need to establish now is that we actually sold it, but for how much? We can approach it this way. We can approach it, number one approach is that in the beginning of your statement of cash flow, there was a loss, an added loss from the disposal of equipment, right? Where is that? What page is that? Please refer to that. And then, do you see it? Do you see the loss on disposal of equipment? Okay, loss on disposal. That was established in the beginning, right? Loss on disposal. Page 588, okay? Wherein, I explained to you, kasi this one appeared in our income statement, di ba? And it reduced our net income reporting. You remember? And then all of a sudden, in the statement of cash flow, we're adding it back, right? Okay. So number one, if it is a loss on that disposal, the reason why we're adding it back is we don't want it counted for operations. Because when it is a property, plant, and equipment, it's not an operating activity account. It is a what account? What kind of activity account?
Investing.
Investing, because it is long-term asset, right? So we take it out of the operating activities by adding it back. That was number one. And we figure that this is how much? How much is the loss?
3,000.
It's 3,000. Okay. How are losses and gains computed for? Losses or gains are computed this way. You get the cash received or the selling price, okay, of the old asset minus the book value of the asset, okay, equals either, if it is positive, it's a positive number, then it is a gain. Because what does that mean? The cash that you receive or the selling price is greater than the book value. But if this is greater than the book value, I mean, if this is greater than
the selling price,
what is it? It is a loss. All right, let's fill this in. If the loss is 3,000 and the book value of the asset in place or in question is how much?
7,000.
How much was the selling price or the cash proceeds?
$4,000.
You get it? So if in case this is unknown, then you figure it out. Okay. Because right now it's all given. Right? Everything's fed to you. What the scenario I am trying to teach you is if something is missing, you can figure it out. Okay? So now, what is the true amount of cash involved in this whole transaction? Is it this loss? Is it the book value? How is cash affected and by which number? Ciara? Which is? It's 4,000, right? it's only 4,000 that really matters. So, in your, and what activity is this all under?
Okay.
What activity in particular in the cash? Why open? What kind of asset? What kind of asset is it? Long-term asset, and therefore, what activity are we talking about?
Investing.
Investing. So what should we see in investing? We should see a sale of equipment for 4,000. Where did that come from? From that litany that I had to go through. And I don't even know if I got to connect. You see what I tried to explain? That's what I was trying to explain. Just one time. Just one line. The 4,000 cash is from that transaction. You see it? Okay? You see now how much heart. While they say that it's so hard to learn, it's really more difficult to teach or to explain. Alright? So this is checked off, right?
Yes.
How about this? Will this affect cash? Remember this? Remember this guy?
Yes.
Will this affect cash, AJ? Yes. How and where? Right. So how does it affect cash? In what direction? It is an outflow. Okay. Which activity? Where? It's still investing. It is still investing. Right? So you will see 25,000 as a negative because it's an outflow, right? Which explains this, right? We have explained this one for the building. Because we just compared, we're now explaining this one as a purchase, right? Because that's what the three accounts say, right? And this clearly is another cash affecting transaction, but this time inflow of 4,000. Because we sold old equipment for 4,000. Does it matter whether that sale gave us a gain or a loss? Does it really matter in the statement of cash flows? We don't care. In fact, we're bringing it, we're either adding it back or deducting, right? Why? Why doesn't it matter again? Because all we care about is how much cash came in or went out, right? And that's what we're trying to distill it with, okay? We're isolating everything that is just that. Cash being affected, okay? So, let me ask you, is this clear for investing? Oh, thanks, Zed. For investing, are we clear on investing? Yes? If you see, let's say, debt securities somewhere in the balance sheet,
long term
what? Long term asset. And you see, let's say, it having, let's just say that this is, instead of buildings, debt security. And you see, let's say this is in 2017, 100. In 2016, 40. What would you do with that, Herbie? What would you do with that information?
60,000 increase.
So there's a 60,000 increase. Okay. What do I do with 60? Ayan natin. What would I do with 60? Okay, number one, what is a debt security as Ernie correctly put it? What is a debt security? This asset is a... It's a long-term asset. Check! Meaning that it is a long-term asset, which activity is expected? Investing. Check! I see there is a change from year to year. 60. 60 up or down?
Up.
What do you think this represents? And how will it be presented in the investing activity section?
Sold.
Make up your mind. Christian, what is your verdict? You purchased more secure. So purchase of investments, and how will it show up? Positive, negative? A negative 60. Because you purchased investment. It will show up here, under here. Okay? Purchase of debt securities minus 60. A use of cash. Right? So, okay, let's walk it through. I know we're still slow here, and it's okay. But that's the kind of checklist that I want you to go through, okay? What asset is it? Ah, okay, long-term asset yun. And therefore, if it is long-term, what does it affect? Ah, okay, investing. Okay, so I know at least which portion, right? Now, what direction? In that direction, you know, how did it affect cash? Oh, it made use of cash. Or maybe, okay, what is this?
Sold.
You sold securities. You sold securities, and therefore, the 60 will be now a source of cash plus. Sold investments, sold debt securities. Okay? Clear? So it's not limited to PP&E or buildings. Anything long-term asset will show up there. Do we get it?
Yes.
Alright. Can we move to financing? Can I get out of investing? Are we comfortable?
Yes.
It's so separate, right? You don't have net income here, you just have shares. And anytime it increases, what does that mean? Did we buy shares? We issued shares. And therefore, when we issue shares or we sell shares,
we gain cash.
Thank you very much, right? So, easily, when we see that common stock went from 50 to 70 as shown in your balance sheet, that means that we sold 20,000, and therefore in financing activity we can expect issuance of common stock bearing a positive sign for the 20,000. Yes?
Yes.
Ito easy. The really hardest part is analyzing equipment. Okay? And then the next one, retained earnings. Okay? Alright, so one naman, payment of cash dividends, if we go back to the additional data page, what page again is that, CRM? 582. If you do not memorize this, the pages in this block of ano, of the textbook in like ano, a few more days, and I don't know what you what is to be expected. I mean, you've been flipping over for the past ilan na. Parang ano na eh, 15 years na tayo nagdaganon. It feels like, right? Isn't this book great? Do we not just ano, read, just maximize our capital investment? Have we depreciated this? How much is the book value of this book? So we acquisition cost of 1.6.
1.6.
Diba? How many sales now?
Two sales.
Okay. One more sale to be depreciated. So maybe 1/3 life. Okay, going back in the additional data, page 582, is there anything mentioned about dividends? Please read it. Alright, that is spoon fed to us. We just take that information and just incorporate it in the financing line. Why is dividends going to be in the investing? Tama ba? Is dividends correctly positioned here?
Yes.
Why again? Can somebody explain to me? It's a loanish.
Right? It's a loanish
and stuff. Although, yeah, okay. Anyone else? Yes, ma'am? Correct. It's part of your equity, diba? In that matrix. Correct? It is really source of capital. Right? And therefore, anytime that it affects capital, no, what is the source of capital? Not the dividends. What is the source of capital? Yeah, but what? I'm sorry, I wasn't clear. Talagang ano na po, I'm really hungry na. I think I'm parang lightheaded na. Ha? Okay, game. Alright. Capital. That is the finance, right? And then investing is using whatever cash we have to buy stuff, right? That is the investing part. So that we can make our whole investment or equity bigger, right? Anyway, so financing is the capital part, okay? One financing way is to sell common stock, right? Another way is to obtain loans or issue bonds payable, right? So that way we can have capital. Okay? Whatever the obligation of the capital is, if it is long-term, okay, is part of financing. One of the obligations that we have when we issue common stock is to declare dividends. That's the matching one. So while dividends alone is not really parang intuitive as part of financing, it is the byproduct of the main financing activity, which is issuing stock. Right? So because we issued stock, we have obligations to pay dividends. Correct? Match yun eh. If you did not issue common stock, do you have dividends to pay? No. Right? The reason why you have dividends is because you issued common stock. And common stock is directly financing. That's the reason. Okay? So this is a byproduct, okay, but then it is still under finance. Now, if we were not given additional information that says that we declared and paid dividends for 29,000, is there an alternative way to figure out through the accounts or through balance sheet accounts? Is there? Can we be a little creative, be creative? Amber, as tingin mo, kunyari, they missed out on the additional information about dividends. Can you figure it out yourself? How much dividends? I guess, right? What is our first step kaya? Just a wild guess. How would we plan to do that? What account can we look at? When do we find dividends? So once again, I'm repeating to you. This is in the event that say dividend information is not supplied with the additional data, right? If that is the case, what first account should we look at and analyze? Common stock? What do you think you will find in common stock? What do we normally find in common stock? If this is common stock, what is the ano? What is the normal balance of common stock? Okay. So, what do we find on the right side of the common stock?
20,000.
So, 20,000. Okay, but then, what do we normally enter on the right side? Find any left-sided entries? Anything? Not for more advanced topics, it's actually retirement, but let's not even go there. So for our level, there is nothing. There is nothing on the left side of the common stock because treasury stock is a separate account altogether, right?
Is
that a class here? No, that's
not there. Oh, best friend is here.
Okay.
Alright? So, what else? Anything else that you find in common stock? So we know that there is issuance, right? Okay. And for this class, there is nothing on the left side. On the left side, right? Where is dividends here? Aaron, where is dividends in common stock? Is dividends entered in common stock? No. It's in retained earnings. Right? This is where you kind of connect, hashtag tawid, all your journal entries. Right? And your computations. Okay, so it is wrong to assume that dividends can be found and analyzed in common stock. You say that it should be retained earnings that we should be analyzing. So, before we analyze, let's figure it out. Okay? Keith, what do we enter in retained earnings? First of all, give me retained earnings balances from beginning to end. Beginning is
48,000.
Ending is. Like this, do you see this? Do you see this in the balance sheet?
Yes.
Guys, follow. Alright. How do you think? think it went from this to this? What do you put on the right side? Ay, but, bakit na, ano na talaga ako? Oh, oh, that's right. Kasi nakahanap ako na ganun eh. Guys, what do you, Anton, what do you normally put on the right side of your paper? With the net income, di ba tama yun? So, where, what do you think that number is and where would you get that information? What do I put here? So, Anton said it is the net income. So, where do you source that? Where do you get this information? Just don't go do the math. Get the information. Where do you get this information, huh? Okay, so get it. No, no, I want you to do the legwork so that you will learn step by step. It's 145 in the income statement. Okay, so let's populate it. You agree, guys? Okay, let's do the math. AJ, does the math work? No, it doesn't. Of course not. Right? Why won't it? Because it's missing one thing. It's missing another number here, which is normally debited to retained earnings. What is that? Dividend. So let me ask you, if the additional information did not provide you with dividends declared and paid, can you figure it out?
Yes.
How much is it, RC?
I just put it down. Oh, 29.
I don't know.
Okay? This is dividends. Okay? And dividends, does it require cash? Does it have any effect on cash?
Yes.
Okay. If it is declared, does it have any?
No.
Declared and paid?
Yes.
Compare you with other batches or other students, diba? You'd be surprised. You're just, you know, getting sharper by the minute. No! No bola!
Stamp ulit sa forehead. Stamp ulit sa forehead.
Si Vinay.
Uno na lahat.
No, no, no.
Stamp siya sa forehead.
29. So we paid dividends, Jen? So, how would we see that? Where? What portion? And how would we see that presented? The dividends. As if we don't already see it. Nyari lang present. We will see it in what portion of the statement of cash flows?
The dividends.
So we will see it in financing. Presented like this, payment of cash dividends. And it will show up as a negative number because we use cash. Okay? So I think all the lights have been So let me ask you, if all of a sudden, if let's say that, here's another scenario. If in the partial balance sheet, okay, in the stockholder's equity, okay? You see, so of course, retained earnings is there, right? You have a number there, correct? And then, of course, paid in capital is here, diba? The total stockholder's equity, paid in capital in excess of par. You have a number here. You still be with me? Okay. And then below here, you see this. Right? Why? How would you handle that for the statement of cash flows? Yeah, now, how would you present it?
Use of cash.
It's a use of cash. It's under financing, okay? And therefore, it is a negative number, right? It will be under here, okay? Repurchase of common stock, right? Or repurchase, or purchase of treasury stock, whatever they call it, right? And then a negative 10. Yes?
Yes.
Oh, wala na. Pwede na kayo mag-asawa. You're all set. Any questions? Any questions? Right? So now, all is presented. You know how to look at operating, right? You know how to analyze investing, right? And then we just touched on financing. Okay? And now you have to total. You total this one plus negative this, right? Plus negative 9, right? Will give you how much? 22,000. Do the math! Do the math. Everybody, do the math. 172 minus negative 141. Tama ba? Or my, hindi, minus 141 lang. Tama ba? Hindi pala. Sorry. Sorry po. Minus 9,000 is equal to 22. Right?
Yes.
Okay. So now, did we do a good job? Let's check. How do we know if we did it correctly? Pretend that this is not yet here. How do we know that this is the correct number? One of two things. You go to balance sheet again, page 582, you look at cash. Cash went from a balance of 33 to 55, which is a change of 22. That's one way to check. Or you take the 22 and you get the beginning cash, which is 33. You add that and it should arrive at the current cash balance. Right? So what did in effect we what did we do exactly? We just computed for the change in cash. We went to the line by line thing, how cash changed from 33 to 55. That's what we tracked and we traced. We did a little investigative work. Okay? Questions. So now, after knowing how to do this, sige, then bibigyan ko na lang kayo ng homework. Okay? Instead of exercise. Kasi sayang yung time. Dapat puro lecture na lang. Operating. Investing. Can you draw a picture or a story out of this? If you were to do a storybook like a children's book, can you tell me a story? Yes, there is a story, and that is what we have to learn. After we know how to crunch numbers and to do good form here, we need to be able to interpret what this means. Okay? And here is the story. Much of, by the way, how much was net income? Okay? income was 145. But in truth, the cash basis, when all of this adjusted, it's really 172. The company generated 172,000 in cash from operations. 172,000 was used, you know, was a surplus out of their blood, sweat, and tears, okay? Their very poor operation. And it was used to buy new stuff. Because they invested, they used all of that money to invest in themselves some more, okay? And whatever is left, they paid shareholders. They shared their earnings with shareholders, right? And, you know, with an offset of, but net sharing, okay? And even with all that, at the end of the day, they still had surplus of 22. That's the story. And what really has the greatest weight is how much can operating generate for funds. Because you might see another company that will probably have something like a change in cash of 100, right? So maybe cash, when looked at the balance sheet, okay, what had 50 for 2016 and then 150 in 2017, right? This could be in somebody's balance sheet. Do you agree? And then we say, whoa, they have lots of money, right? And look, you know, it's such a big jump. From 2000 to 2017, will we be wowed? I think so. I think I will. But then, what if I find out that the story, empty with math, I don't have, I know, I don't have this math. I have this, I have this, and then, ilan na yan, Peter? Tama ba ito?
Yeah.
Ay, baliktad.
It's
like this?
Yes.
Okay. What if this big, big jump is this story? What is this story? What is this story? It's not exactly a net loss. They did not make enough money from operations. They were short, right? They operated and they operated and they did not collect enough from customers, right? And therefore, they were short and they had to pay obligations, current obligations, right? Like the government, like employees, like Meralco, like the landlord. Where did they get money? Oh my gosh, they started selling whatever they have. They're on a fire sale, garage sale. Let's sell our property, plant, and equipment. Ay, hindi pala nag-invest pala. Mali ako doon. I should have done it.
Investing zero.
Positive,
yes.
Parang anti-climactic na din. So I'll do 100. So this is negative 200. This is now 300. Is that good?
Yeah.
Okay. Is this a better story?
Yeah. Okay. It's a worse
story. Oh my gosh! Oh my gosh! I don't have money. What do I have to do?
Hello.
Ay, my gosh, let me sell whatever I have, my old stuff, right? Just to get, turn it into cash so that I can pay some. Oops, it's not yet enough. Why don't I sell my soul as well? Right? And let's just say that you find out the breakdown of this, diba? Would be issue common stock. And issue bonds, and then the ironic is they gave dividends. if you break it down? I mean, are they worthy of issuing or declaring dividends amidst this catastrophe?
No.
Listen, will you ever, ever deduce that story just by looking at your cash balance?
No.
Never. Never. That's what the statement of cash flow offers us. A story to interpret. Okay? That's why we are compelled to learn it. That's why it is reserved also for the last. Because it is so different from forming or presenting a balance sheet and an income statement. Remember those two? We had to go to source journal entries and follow it through a posting of ledgers and then with a trial balance adjusting, etc. This one doesn't need that. It just needs those two finished products, balance sheet and income statement. You get it? Okay. Questions? So we've done the legwork, the hard part of computing. Are we good? We know a little about interpreting the story, right? Okay? Because what I'm saying is, these are just quick views, diba, of totals. You can still do a double click, so to speak, or a deep dive, kind of like this 300. You will, if you double click, kumbaga, you'll see that there are dividends pala paid, and there's common stock issued, etc., etc. Okay? Questions? So, voila, this is it. Let's try to answer this. Which is an example? Of a cash flow from an investing activity. Which one is investing here?
D.
It's not D?
No.
Why not D? D is operating. D is very operating. Right? And A is what?
Financing.
Financing. How about I know that B is, I think, financing.
Yeah.
But what's another term for that activity? What's another term for that transaction? Give me two words.
Treasury.
Oh, see? You don't realize you're just so sharp now. I know, right? I'm so happy. Oh, wow! It just fits my heart when I see transformations. Better in the
sun.
Alright. So this is a questions. We will meet tomorrow.
Yeah.
Maybe we should devote tomorrow for just exercise, tama ba yun? Or should we do a little exercise na lang tao and do something? Exercise tayo ngayon! Bukas na free cash flow! Para may ano?
Is that true?
Okay. Yeah, let's do something together or whatever. I don't know. Together.